This is part two of a four-part series of videos
on how to optimize your immunohistochemistry protocols. If you've got your tissue prepped and ready to go, we'll move on to the next steps in the staining protocol. Step two, primary antibody diluent. Good IHC protocols provide the proper conditions for a specific binding event to occur.
It is therefore essential that you calibrate the ionic strength
and pH of the antibody diluent to the specific antigen-epitope interaction you are trying to detect. TBST is commonly used for this purpose. It is isotonic to normal saline and buffered around physiological pH. These conditions mimic the environment that antibodies and antigens encounter during the natural course of an immune system interaction.
As a result, TBST works well for many antibodies, such as this antibody for phospho-EGF receptor. But it doesn't work for all antibodies.
For example,
PLK rabbit monoclonal antibody
produced limited signal when it was diluted in TBST.
But the signal slightly improved when we diluted it in signal-stain antibody diluent.
Since each commercially available diluent mixture is proprietary, the investigator will need to determine the suitability of each on a case-by-case basis.
For PLK1, changing the diluent improved the signal, but only slightly. We needed to take the protocol optimization further. Coming up next, step 3.